More than 7 million displaced and over 12,000 dead. This is not the Democratic Republic of Congo, Ukraine, or Gaza. This is Sudan.
Well, Sudan's humanitarian situation is certainly one of the worst.
The war in Sudan has unfortunately been forgotten.
So what's at stake for Sudan and the region? Before we go any further, let's unpack how the country got here. In 2019, a civilian uprising ousts autocratic ruler Omar al-Bashir. A transitional government is put in place. In October 2021, it is overthrown by these two men, the leader of the paramilitary Rapid Support Forces, General Mohamed Hamdan Dagalo, widely known as Hemedti, and the leader of the Sudanese Armed Forces, General Abdel Fattah al-Burhan. The two former friends could not agree on the direction the country should take, and the war broke out in April 2023. So that's the background, but what is at stake? Let's start with Darfur. The region has recently seen some of the worst atrocities with terrifying echoes of ethnic cleansing that happened 20 years ago. At the time, the Bashir government used Arab militia, collectively known as the Janjaweed, to brutally put down a rebellion by non-Arab Darfuri groups. The Janjaweed militia was later transformed into the RSF.
What many people fear are signs of wide-scale ethnic cleansing. People fear that genocide might be returning to Darfur as the Rapid Support Forces and their allied Arab militias appear to be in control of most of the region.
But there is a danger that more armed groups may be drawn into the conflict, which would inevitably escalate the war.
Some of the rebel groups that are threatening to depart from their position of neutrality are ethnically from the Zaghawa group, which is the dominant ethnic group in power in Chad. So many people fear that if al-Fashir is attacked and these armed groups depart from their neutral position, that that fight could embroil Chad.
UN experts have expressed alarm at the escalation of violence in Sudan, particularly sexual violence committed primarily by the Rapid Support Forces. With so many forced to flee, including 3 million children, the humanitarian crisis in Sudan is deepening and spilling into neighboring countries.
Obviously, 1.3 million people moving across the borders into Chad, Ethiopia, Eritrea, South Sudan, Central African Republic. These are going to create burdens for the host communities where those refugees reside. We have received a number of concerns from the Chadian side on that, as well as from the refugees themselves about the level of support they're getting.
Now, this conflict also has the added challenge of vested interest from various international players.
Sudan's war is actually a global war. The Sudanese Armed Forces is supported by Egypt, by Iran, by Turkey, by Saudi Arabia, and the Rapid Support Forces have been supported both financially and through munitions transfers by the United Arab Emirates. This means that even if a deal between the generals can be reached, the proxy nature of this war means that solutions need to be found elsewhere as well.
So with all these dynamics at play, what is at stake for Sudan?
The territorial integrity of Sudan as we know it. Many speak about a sort of a Libya scenario of a split country, but we may indeed already be seeing the fracturing of the country into many pieces.
With the two generals at war, coupled with the effects of climate change, humanitarian organizations warn that the situation will only get worse in 2024 and that the country is headed towards a hunger catastrophe. All this will deepen one of the world's worst humanitarian crises.